Proud Passage.
When I came to Toronto, I studied, but I wound up starting to write music for J. Frank Willis.
Ladies and gentlemen, CBC Wednesday Night presents a new play by Joseph Shule, set on the rugged coast of Cape Breton Island, last of the far-flung Hebrides. The original musical score was written and orchestrated by Philip Nimmons and is conducted by Samuel Hersenhorn. The production is directed by J. Frank Willis. Proud Passage.
We did nothing but sea stories, it seemed, because he was from Halifax, and he used to seem like went to seventh heaven when he'd get talking about Peggy's Cove or the Blue Nose, and all about the East Coast. But what the biggest thing I feel in retrospect is that I heard everything I wrote.
This evening on Stage 52, the CBC presents Hedda Gabler by Henrik Ibsen. Radio adaptation by John Bethune, with original music composed by Philip Nimmons and conducted by Samuel Hersenhorn. Production and direction, Essa W. Young.
The listener and the theater audience will bring back one artist as a winner next week.
Which brings us right up to the Canadian composer spot. This is where we present the premier performance of a new Canadian composition, specially commissioned by us. As you know, these compositions are judged at the end of each series by a special board headed by Jeffrey Waddington, the well-known conductor. On the basis of interest and originality, they select one work for a second performance and a double fee. Tonight, we are to hear the work of Philip Nimmons of Vancouver. Lamont?
Phil Nimmons is 28 years old. And though his home is in Vancouver, his study and work have taken him far afield. In the midst of his studies for a medical career, he switched to music and went to the Juilliard School of Music in New York as a scholarship student. After 2 years of clarinet study there, he moved to Toronto for further study at the Royal Conservatory. At the present time, he is a busy member of Toronto's musical fraternity, as a member of various orchestras, and as a composer of dramatic scores for CBC programs. It's interesting to note that while today much of his work is in the medium of serious music, he spent a considerable time as clarinetist and arranger for the well-known Ray Norris Quintet. His composition tonight is a whimsical study of the life and loves of a marionette. Here then is John Adaskin and the Opportunity Knox Orchestra and Marionette.
For me personally, the CBC has been a teacher, an educator for me, and I got paid at the same time. You know, I think any expertise I developed as an orchestrator resulted from my work with the CBC. It also nourished my spirituality as a jazz musician right from the beginning in Vancouver. But it also nourished, again, just me at this present moment, broadening my musical appreciation in a sense, because I became associated with not only jazz musicians but other studio musicians and of both classical and jazz and also vocal music and things like that. So those were all influences on all of us.